I am Mrs. Divya Soni from Ma Kalyanika Public School, Pendurandu. Today, students, we are going to study something about adjectives. As you know, it is also a part of speech. And what does an adjective mean? An adjective is a word that describes about the noun. Whether the noun is in number, whether it is in manner, whether it is in quality, whether it is in quantity, whatever it is. Okay. When a word describes about a noun, it is known as an adjective. Okay. So, the describing word about the noun is adjective. So, let us practice in this exercise. Here, Kartik is wearing a striped shirt. Which type of shirt he is wearing? Here Kartik is proper noun, shirt is a noun. So here stripe is describing its shirt. Okay, stripe is describing about Kartik's shirt. So which is the adjective over here? Striped. Which is the adjective? Striped. Now look at the second sentence. Tom Sawyer sat under a shady tree. Here tree is a noun. Which type of tree it was? It was a shady tree. So, adjective here is a shady. Okay. Now, come on to the third sentence. My younger brother studies in class 2. Okay. Which type of brother? Brother is a noun. Which brother? Younger brother. So, younger indicates the adjective in the sentence. Okay. Fourth sentence. Grandpa sat on the wooden chair. Which type of chair? Wooden chair. So, wooden here indicates the adjective. Okay. There was 20 people. How many people were there? 20 people. Okay. So, 20 describes about the adjective. This is the case when you are talking about one noun. When you are talking about the description of one noun, that is the simple adjectives. Okay, when we have to find out, when we have to indicate about the adjectives about a single noun. But there are conditions when there are more than one noun or more than two nouns. Then what is the condition? Then the degrees of adjective come. What comes? Degrees of adjective. Whether it is a positive degree. Positive degree means when you are talking about only one noun. Okay. Then you are talking about positive degree. Okay. When you are talking about two nouns. When you are comparing about two nouns, the quality of two nouns, then you are talking about comparative degree. Which type of degree? Comparative degree. And whenever you are talking about more than two nouns, and you are selecting the best out of that. Okay. So, that is the superlative degree. So, have you understood? Whenever you are talking about only description about only one noun, you are talking about positive degree. Whenever you are talking about two nouns, description of two nouns, then you are talking about comparative degree. And when you are talking about more than two nouns and you are comparing among that more than two nouns, so you are talking about superlative degree. Okay, students? Now, there is also some difference in the three types of degrees in the adjective. So, first type of words is a simple word. Simple word means in which a word is formed by only one word. Okay? By only one word. That means, take for instance, I have written here small. Small is a only one word. Okay. That is not a combination of two or three words. Okay. It is a simple word. Okay. Whenever you are talking about any simple word, you have to add what? Ear or ear. It depends upon the spelling of the noun or spelling of the adjective. Okay. So, whenever you are talking about simple word, you simply have to add IER or ER to the verb to make it a comparative degree, and EST to the word, to the simple word to make it a superlative degree. Okay, students? One more thing is that I have told you positive degree is for only one noun. Okay, comparative degree is for two nouns. Okay, and superlative degree is for the more than two nouns. Okay, so here we have simply added IER or ER to the word, and here we have added EST to the word. Okay, before this superlative degree, we always put the adjective the. Remember this thing. Okay, before the superlative degree, we always put the what article? The. Okay, before the superlative degree, we always put the article in front of it to show that it is the best or it is the worst. Okay, so and here in the comparative degree, whenever you are comparing two things, you have to use than after an adjective. Okay, here what you have to add? Than. And here the. Okay, in comparative degree we are adding than after the adjective, and in superlative degree before adjective we are adding the article. Okay, this is the most important thing to identify the sentence, whether it is in positive degree, whether it is in comparative degree, or whether it is in superlative degree. It is the best solution to find out in which degree we have to form the sentence. Okay, now the next thing, I have told you about the simple word. Next comes the complex or the compound word. Okay, compound means when a word is formed by adding two simple words. Here, beauty and full. Two words are there, beauty and full. Here, import and. That means important. Okay, here beauty and full means beautiful. That means these are compound words. Whenever we are talking about any compound words, we have to add more when we have to prepare a comparative degree before an adjective, and most before an adjective to make it a superlative degree. Okay, what we have to add? We have to add more before the adjective to make it comparative, and before adjective we have to put most to make it a superlative. Okay, this rule that which I have told you earlier, that then is present in comparative degree and the is present in superlative degree, remain as such. Okay, it doesn't change with the adjectives. Okay, other than this, there are some adjectives which can't be easily changed, which doesn't have any specific rule. Okay, these adjectives are known as irregular adjectives. What they are known as? Irregular adjectives. Like good becomes better in comparative degree and best in superlative degree. Similarly, bad becomes worse in comparative degree and worse in superlative degree. Is it clear, students? Okay, students, let us revise once again. What are adjectives? Adjectives are the qualifying word or the word that describes about a noun. Here, I have shown you some examples to how to identify adjective in a sentence, where it is present. Now, in this time, we are talking about only one noun. When we are talking about more than one noun, then more than one noun or more than two nouns, then we are talking about degree of adjectives. What we are talking about? Degrees of adjective. There are three degrees of adjective: positive degree, comparative degree, and superlative degree. Whenever we are talking about any one or adjective, then we are dealing with positive degree. When we are dealing with to announce that we are dealing with comparative degree, and whenever we are dealing with more than two nouns, then we are dealing with superlative degree of an adjective. I have told you about the simple verb. What happens in the simple verb? We simply add er or ier to the verb to make it a comparative, and est to make it a superlative. Okay? In which case? In simple verb. Okay? Whenever we are talking about any compound verb, in compound verb, we put more before an adjective to make it comparative, and most in front of adjective to make it a superlative. Okay, students? And some are irregular adjectives which changes by itself. There is no any such rule for it. Okay, like good becomes better in comparative and best in superlative. Similarly, bad becomes worse in comparative and worst in superlative. And one thing more I have told you, that in comparative degree we use the word than after adjective, and in superlative what we use, the article in front of adjective. Okay, this is the identification mark to identify the sentence whether we have to put an adjective in comparative degree or in positive degree or in superlative degree. Students, I hope you would have understood this video, or you would have understood the adjectives properly. Try to solve your exercise at home to get it much better. Thank you, students.